vor drei Wochen gehabt. Daher ein Kampf, ein Sieg und unser
Well, a couple of super middleweights get ready to go for six rounds here. On the right in the black is Harold Roberts from Kansas City, Missouri. And his opponent is Marcus Baer out of Germany. Young man they have a great deal of hopes of, even though this is only his second professional fight. Well, Roberts comes in with a limited amateur career, but comes in at 7-1 as a pro as they get ready to go again for six rounds in the super middleweight division. Roberts will definitely have a height advantage over Baer at 6 feet for Roberts and roughly about 5'9½" for Baer. Let's see if that equates into a pretty good reach advantage for, again, which is setting up the southpaw in Roberts. He does tell me that he does like to switch a bit, so we'll see if he stays southpaw
for the fight.
And he fights a southpaw as well, the way that Baer is setting up as well, so it'd be a countering here to see which one of these guys can score early. And it's Baer that scores with a good combination downstairs. Not much damage, though. Roberts finds the center combination back, getting very aggressive in round one. Roberts being looked at by the referee is almost to offer a warning. Baer digging that hand to the side and throws a pretty good left hand to the head. Comes back downstairs. Roberts retaliates with a good combination of his own.
Break! Break!
Both fighters just trying to get comfortable here in round one. Roberts has just flown in here the last couple of days, says he feels very acclimated to the situation here in Vienna. We'll see if that equates into being comfortable through the first round. After that, it's kind of up to the corners to make adjustments and see what they can do. Roberts, you being thought by Baer. Roberts throwing combinations, most of those being caught on the glove and the elbows by Baer. There's a good straight left hand, just sailed by the cheek that time of Baer. Digging left hand up there. He likes to work downstairs, not come upstairs all that much. And now Roberts with a pretty good clumping right hand starts to back up there a little bit. He decides to stand and fight in the center of the ring. Halfway through round number one, scheduled for 6 tonight in Vienna. There you can see likes to lead with that left of the body, comes back with a right hand. One characteristic of a southpaw, but that's the way that he's fighting this one. Seemed trying to lead with the left, then faked the left and came with the right hand. Roberts was able to fend it off nicely. Killing a feeling out process so far for both fighters. Baer may have a slight advantage. Matter of fact, digs an uppercut that time to Roberts. Roberts threw a wild right hand over the top. That European peekaboo style up there. Good left hand off an air break. Roberts with a lunging style. You can see that wild, wild swing that he takes on his way out of a possible clinch. Baer's coming off a TKO win over Eric Davis in nearby Munich, happening on November the 23rd. And of course on the Maska and Virgil Hill fight. 1-6 rounds by a knockout. Closing seconds of round number one. Roberts out of Kansas City, Missouri in the black. Now backpedaling, kicking away from Baer of Germany. Baer set to go 6 tonight for super middleweight. Quite a production going on here in Germany. This, of course, expect to be a packed house, an early fight being fought here as Roberts against Baer. Good look at Baer. Does not set in the corner, interesting enough. 25 years of age, being encouraged to keep going to the body, then try to come upstairs. He has not done much of that in the early parts of the round one. Good condition athlete, as you can see, but again, does not set in between rounds. Roberts on the right of your screen is setting. out of Kansas City, Missouri, 27 years of age.
This is nasty.
Keeping away with a jab. Youngster Roberts, who started at the age of 14, been fighting as a fighter for 13 years as they ready for round two. In action in that round one, it was Bear who probably got the better part of it, and officially at ringside, a 10-9 round for Bear. Roberts circling again, trying to find an opening here. Bear in the goal, and Roberts in the black. Roberts the American, Bear from Germany. Good, patient boxer is Bear. Got a good set of legs under him. Crouch as well, comes out of that crouch. You can see him plunging with that good left hand. Roberts tries to counter, gets a couple of good left hands in, including a digging left hand to the body. Roberts, I guess you would call him a free swinger, wild and woolly. As he comes out of every clinch, looking like a windmill. Bear staying within him side, digs that left hook again to the body. See Roberts having to try to crouch just a little bit to get down to the shorter Bear rather than using that reach advantage with a jab and following up behind it. Has not done so. As we have fought a minute here in round two. Kind of a token jab by Roberts at the moment. Both fighters have stayed in the southpaw stance. Have not done any switching. Now Roberts switches a little bit to the right as he goes into the corner. There's a warning for a hold on Bear, a warning for Roberts to keep the punches up. Rare not, Roberts not doing much damage at all with just that little flipping left jab. Bear just waits for him to get out of position and digs that left hand to the body again. Good close look at the 25-year-old German, Marcus Bear. Good solid amateur career here. In the Alps. You can see how he uses those legs along with those good shoulders just to try to crowd Roberts into the ropes. Bear again, just a lead right, trying to set up the left hand. Got a counter a little off of that, and the fact that he has used the lead left and then followed with the right hand. This time he digs the right to the body again. Roberts ducking down, referee encouraging him to stay upright, and also to avoid any low punches as he tries to dig low. Okay. And Roberts goes down in the second round. Indicating it didn't hurt him, but he is down. That'll certainly not help him on the scorecards as he probably, for the most part, lost round one and could go to a 10-8, and now they're up on the edge and they're going to stop the fight. So the corner of Roberts, they say he's had enough, and Roberts will go down, and Bear will win it officially on a TKO in the second round. Bear had done the damage early on in round one, and again at the start of round two. The crushing left hook to the body had taken some steam out of Roberts. Roberts continued to try to duck away from those punches, but again, as you saw at the bitter end, he goes down again, and officially the TKO goes to Bear as he wins for the second time as a pro and wins it here on the undercard of the big fight here in Vienna tonight. Let's watch again and see the end of this. There's that token left, humps back with the right, comes up over the top on Roberts. As Roberts ducks in, there's the left hand that finally puts him down, even though he was on his way down. Another look at it from a different angle. Just a glazing right hand with the left hand to the side of the face, and that's the one that finally did him in. With a good left hook by a good, strong-looking German fighter by the name of Marcus Bear. He wins on a TKO in the second round here tonight in Vienna. They are getting ready for the official announcement and his celebration as both fighters come to the center of the ring. You can see the good crowd here in Vienna tonight. So Marcus Bear comes up with the TKO in the second round as Roberts, which could be pounding in the first, but not do so in the second as Bear celebrates in Vienna with a win tonight on World Championship Boxing.
So, und damit...